Hi, I'm Rick Lumpkin at NOAA AOML. I'm a principal investigator of the Pirata Northeast Extension Program. The overall Pirata program, Pirata stands for the Prediction and Research Moored Array in the Tropical Atlantic, is a joint effort between three countries to understand climate fluctuations in this region. The backbone, these red dots, was deployed in 1997 by France here and Brazil here. The general distribution of the moorings allows for us to see east-west variations, which are analogous to El Niño in the Pacific, and north-south variations, which have very large impacts on rainfall around the continental United States, Africa, and South America. In later years, we realized that we needed additional moorings to understand other phenomena better. For example, the Brazilians added a southwest extension. A consortium of countries added a southeast extension. And the United States decided that we needed more observations here in the northeast, where easterly waves come off of Africa and develop into tropical cyclones and hurricanes, and often don't develop. We want to understand why some years are particularly warm and some years aren't. And to be able to do that in numerical models, we need observations of these different anomalous years. Buoys in this region give us those measurements. A buoy at the surface, which measures meteorological variables such as wind, to air temperature, and humidity, and extending down from that to 500 meters beneath the surface, a number of sensors measuring temperature, salinity, and ocean current. They also allow us to observe things like dust coming off of Africa and the oxygen minimum zone, a region of low oxygen at about 500 meters depth in the tropical Atlantic, which we know over the last several decades has been steadily decreasing in how much oxygen it has, perhaps due to long-scale climate change. Every year, we go out on a vessel to service these buoys and collect observations in the region. The ship typically leaves from Barbados, goes to these different moorings, and then returns to the home port. And while we're visiting these moorings, we also collect conductivity temperature depth casts to a depth of 1,500 meters to sample the upper ocean temperature, oxygen, and salinity, as well as a lowered ADCP to measure ocean currents. While we're out there on the vessel, we collect additional observations by deploying surface drifters, Argo floats for profiling upper ocean conditions, and launches of atmospheric sondes and ozone sondes to look at atmospheric profiles and help validate satellite observations.
Hi, I'm Renelis Perez. I'm an associate scientist in the Physical Oceanography Division of NOAA AOML, and I'm going to tell you a little bit more about some of the moorings that are part of the Pirata Array. What you see here on the map is the entire Pirata Array. Traditional methods for measuring ocean currents typically leave a gap in the top 40 meters. In order to better understand the ocean currents in the top 40 meters, in February 2015, we deployed a new type of mooring in the Pirata Array. This new TACOS mooring was outfitted with 11 current meters. This TACOS mooring will allow us to fill the gap and give us a more complete picture of the ocean currents in the area.
Hi, I'm Greg Foltz, a scientist in the Physical Oceanography Division at AOML. I'll talk a little bit about our efforts here to ensure that the data coming from the Pirata Northeast Extension moorings is of the highest possible quality. The PNE moorings are located directly downwind from the Sahara and the Sahel regions of Africa, which together represent the largest source of mineral dust on the planet. This is a satellite image which shows a typical dust storm coming off of West Africa over the eastern tropical Atlantic Ocean. The dust coats the buoys and is meteorological instruments. This is especially important for the solar radiometer, which measures the amount of energy that the ocean absorbs from the sun. There's a visible film of dust coating this radiometer, and this led to a severe low bias in the solar radiation record from the mooring, as the film of dust reflected sunlight away from the radiometer. These biases make it very difficult to determine how much energy is received from the sun, and also what drives changes in sea surface temperature in the tropical Atlantic. Currently, these corrections are made after the fact, when the moorings are recovered, which is not ideal. We've therefore developed a new technique to clean these radiometer domes while they're deployed at sea. This new system will improve the quality of the real-time data received from the moorings